Define my travels as you can, as they say. What's going on, everyone out there? Hello, members of the wonderful GOG community. How's everyone doing? Welcome to a Tuesday night stream, February 2nd, 2016. This is episode 19 of Pen and Pixels. I am your host, Arvin Elleron, and I hope you guys are doing very well as we move already past the first month of the year. Just, you know, in case you haven't been keeping up, time moves quickly. And so that's what's going on with us as well. I hope you guys are doing well and looking forward to a fun stream tonight as we continue with Wasteland 2. Want to thank, first of all, Outstar. I thought long and hard about how to sort of express this in the proper way. And I think the only way that I can really express it is I. So anyway, that's going to become the ultimate inside joke, by the way. No one who did not see this stream is going to have any idea what the hell we're talking about, and they're just going to be like, you know, this is what happens, man. You know, you think you got a good stream team assembled, you think you know what you're doing, and then all of a sudden they just go nuts and start saying I at each other and mumbling. So, but anyway, that was a fun game to watch. It was interesting, and we're going to have a chance to play some games here as well with Wasteland 2. Before I do that, just a quick reminder to follow the stream if you have not done so already. Please make sure to follow the channel and follow all of us individually, including Outstar, who's been doing a lot of wonderful streams on her own channel as well. I'm going to be playing for you from 7 p.m. Eastern until 10 p.m. Eastern, at which point I will give way to Retrograde Tom, who's going to be reaving some souls with Legacy of Kain, and then we're going to be moving on to and then I'm going to be moving on after that to back to my channel at around 10:30 p.m. Eastern, where I am going to be finishing up with Demons of the Deep, our Fighting Fantasy Gamebook playthrough. And I also want to mention to folks who may be watching me from my channel, we have a couple of new emotes, better TTV emotes to roll out. So I'm very excited to show you guys what those are. But that'll be on my channel later on, and hopefully you'll be able to stick around for Retrograde Tom as well. Last thing that I want to mention before I get started is I want to congratulate all the folks from GOG and elsewhere who did so well in Arvanaut Idol. As some of you may know, on my channel, there were their finals on the channel had four people, and they included former GOG team member Classicor, Zeta Shade, who was a friend of another GOG team member, Pyron Jade, and Matcat Plays, and Mega Pie Man PhD. And GOG was very well represented. My Pie Man came out fourth ultimately. Matcat took second, and Classicor ended up winning the contest with his story. So it was a lot of fun. I enjoyed watching it and being a part of it, and I hope everyone enjoyed it as well. So thank you guys. And I only mentioned it because of Arvanaut Idol, because of all the GOG influence. So GOG did very, very well, and that's what I wanted to mention. So with that said, we're going to get into some Wasteland 2, and hopefully you guys are going to be able to help me out with some things here, with some character building, as I try to actually enjoy myself with the game and not totally min-max. We'll start here. Hello, everybody. Good to see everyone. I wanted to mention, by the way, that I'm wearing today my shirt, which is the theory... I don't know if I can... This is what happens when you have a sweater. This is what happens when you try to do this in the winter. The theory of gamativity, GM equals PC squared, which in my estimation means either that one game master is worth two player characters, or that a game master is worth more than a personal computer. And I think that's probably true in either case. But anyway, that's what I am wearing today. I have not played, well, I shouldn't say that. I've played about an hour, Jim, of Wasteland 2, and that's about it. And when I did, I basically just created one character, and then I got a bunch of characters together, basically just took a bunch of, like, pre-made characters so that I could check it out. So I've played maybe an hour, maybe 2 hours at most, and that's as far as I got. So I know very little about it, and I've never assembled a full party. I started assembling the party last week on this channel during the show, and I'm going to continue to assemble it today. I do want to say that although much of my show for the next how many months is going to be Wasteland 2, I am going to take a break in the middle of it because I am going to want to play the Agatha Christie series. EA is going to be, in all likelihood, debuting that show, that game. But then after that, hopefully I'm going to get a chance to do a series of the Agatha Christie, and I am going to want to do that before making this the All Wasteland 2 All the Time channel. So we will see, but I'm looking forward to that. Anyway, so that's the deal. That's right, Shatter. Not a strip stream. That's a totally different thing. All right. So with all that said, let's get into it, folks, and let us move into the Wasteland. Let's do it up. Wasteland. Huzzah. All right. Right. Well, yeah, and I'm trying to do that, Jim. The hard part for me has been I've been trying to do this in such a way that I can actually role play it. because I don't like creating characters that like fit certain builds only so that you can, like, I don't know. So I'm trying to make a character. My main character is supposed to be super charismatic. Supposed to be super charismatic and super like persuasive. Those are sort of the main things. I wanted to make him then also a sniper rifle guy. Was not as successful with that, which I thought was, unfortunate, but oh well. But that's sort of the theory. So we'll see whether or not I'm able to continue to produce a character that I actually want. That would be lovely if I could. All right, hang on a second here. Why am I not able to? I don't know why. All right, I'll deal with that later. Okay, you played about 8 hours in a new one. Much better than the fall party you had before. All right, cool. It's time for character creation. Well, we already did two of them, Dragon, in fairness. I already did two. Oh, wait. See, those are my previous. Those are the ones that I played for a couple hours when I was playing earlier. But, let's see. So, we want a new game. Yes, and I want to load. And I want to load my two characters that I've got so far. Create custom squad. Select existing ranger. All right. Arvin Elleron. This is my guy. Arvin Elleron had always valued two things above all: family and knowledge. When the second thing he cared about wasn't enough to save his first, he knew he had to set out to find a new path and a new family to go with it. He carries with him a deep compassion for the downtrodden and the oppressed, a hatred of bullies, and a seriously badass sniper rifle, which isn't even true because he can't use a sniper rifle because the game said no. But anyway, its name, the lesson, because knowledge is power. I'm gonna have to adjust that. Alrighty, so there's that. Then we're gonna select an existing one. The seemingly boring color palette. Oh, we'll see, Pyro. Yeah, it's a good question. I'm not always a huge fan of that, but we'll see. Okay, now these are the two characters that I created last time. I created a character who had, as you can see, basically I wanted to make this guy, once it turned out that I couldn't really do the sniper rifle thing, I wanted to make this guy into basically a super charismatic, personally appealing guy who can persuade people to do different things and who can attract a lot of people to his cause. But I also wanted him to be basically awesome with bladed weapons because apparently the sniper thing wasn't going to happen. So he is essentially Book of Eli guy. So yeah, you can make your own backgrounds. Yeah. So that's the deal with that. Doc Brown, I wanted to make as you can see, he's basically my medic, my surgeon, my all around sort of guy. Again, Doc Brown. If Doc Brown from Back to the Future was in a post-apocalyptic universe, and if it was 1.2 gigawatts, I feel like Doc Brown, this would be the representation of him. So that's what we've got with there is toaster repair, etc. So I've got two people so far. So I've got one guy who's got shotguns. I've got one guy who's bladed. So I feel like I need a distance person who can also do some computer hacking. So basically my third per I basically need to get that skill associated with it. So we've got Doc Brown. So now I need I should probably make with this one a sniper rifle computer hacker type. Let's see. You already miss out, Starwalker? Well, you know what, Morton, listen. I apologize that I cannot be an attractive Polish woman. That is not possible for me. So you're just gonna have to put up with a devilishly handsome American male. And, if that's not good enough, then it'll have to be that. You might want to spend. I am not a loot whore completionist at all, in the least. But I do agree when you say the thing about spending skill points on all knowledge skills, some of those skills come in handy for approaching or even resolving certain situations in a good or at least unfavorable way. That's a different sort of thing. Oh, thank you, Dizzy. Arv, can I make the sniper person? I'm going to have you guys help me. You guys will help. Oh my goodness. So I don't know. I am gonna want to have someone who's awesome at like hacking and opening and disarming things. Like, so why don't we do this? We're going to make a sniper who is a, well, here's the skills we need. We need someone who can open things, disarm things, repair things, and hack things. We need open, disarming, repairing, and hacking. So I feel like one of these people should be opening and disarming, and the other one should be repairing and hacking. So let's make the sniper, who's kind of a loner, let's make her this way. Let's see. A sniper name. A good sniper name. Let's see. Can I play? I want to be hacker. Hackers are cool. Do you want me to name you Outstar? All right. I'm going to put, this is complete fan service. I want to say this is never going to get accepted by the big wigs at Marvel, but I'm going to do it just because I like her. So Outstar, I'm not going to say Outstar Walker. I'm going to say Outstar. Outstar is a female. Her age, this is not based upon her actual characteristics. So I'm just going to come up with an age. This is not saying that Outstar is actually 25. I'm going to say that. I'm going to say that Outstar is, let's see. I'm going to say that she is, got to think about this. Indigenous. I think definitely indigenous. Smokes? No. None of my people smoke because that's terrible for you. Ethnicity. Oh, but see, there's no, okay, European. I was about to say, I had a feeling that Outstar was not going to be a fan of me making her Russian. Can you imagine if I'm like, oh, you Polish people, you Russian people, you're all the same. That would have gone over real well. So she's European. All right. Outstar. One of most compelling in the business. It's been hacking and repairing since before she learned to walk. The truth is that without her toys to keep her company, endlessly and disassembling as her argued in the house outside, she might have ended up instead she became technical whiz, certified loner, one with a good heart. Oh, and she can code. ASIC. Okay. Outstar. One of the most compelling peeps in the business. Yes, good call. Technical peeps. One of the most compelling technical peeps in the business. She's been hacking and repairing since before she learned to walk. The truth is that without her toys to keep her company, endlessly assembling and disassembling them in her small room as her parents argued in the house outside, she might have ended up in much worse shape. Instead, she became what she is, a technical whiz, a certified loner, but someone with a good heart and better disposition. Oh, and she can code all the way back to basic, because that's badass. I don't want to say that. As her parents argued, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, good. Now we have to change. Let's customize her appearance. Here we go. Technical Peeping Tom class. Here we go. Right. Now, let's see what we got here. I don't think she's going. No, there's no way. No, Outstar's not going to get a hat. Outstar? What? No, absolutely not. Instead, we're going to deal with hair. What? God, no. What the hell is that? Eh. Why? Really? Oh, now, see, okay. That's fine, except it looks like Harley Quinn, but otherwise. Hey, what's up, Coyote? There is Akana, yeah. I want to make, there is, but I want to make her indigenous. There's only one pink hair type? What? Really? I can't change the hair color. Whoa! Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Bridget Nielsen. I don't know whether I could buy this. I don't know if I can buy this hair. I don't know. I don't know, guys. What do you think? I don't know if this really fits the... Does this fit the Outstar model? I don't really... I don't know. It feels like... I don't know. All right. I'll go with it. Let's see. Oh, ho. No. What? What? Eh? R? I'm tempted to do this. I'm tempted to do this. Okay. Torso. What? No. Eh. Maybe. It's got to be like a hacker outfit. That's weird. Now she looks like who's the hacker in the Assassin's Creed series who shows up later on? Not Lucy, but the other one, the technical one that helps with the Animus and everything. Does anyone remember? She looks a little bit like that. I can't remember her name though. This is getting worse and worse. We don't need another hero. We don't need to go the way home. All we want is left beyond this terrible jacket. That's terrible. I don't know. Would she wear that? See that? Okay. See, that's possible right there. That's possible. It's goofy as all hell, but okay, what is that? Are you carrying a gourd? Outstar, in your hacking, do you like carry a gourd? What the hell is that? Yeah, I. I typically order a... What I like to do as a hacker is spend my time carrying a gourd. What the hell is that? I don't even... Okay, anyway, no. Possibly. No. Eh. What? That's her pet rock. Her pet rock. No, I like this. She's got that little side pack going on. All right. Ah, that's not bad. Maybe. That's possible. I like that because of the other power. Oh, wait a second. Yeah, but what is this? Wyatt Earp? What's the Western look? I don't understand why we need to... Okay. That's possible. What's up, Shadowed? Why? I know, but like... I know, but I just... Okay. Why? This is like if I were making a librarian. I don't even... That's terrible. That's something I'm not going to get into. Sea of Memories. Yeah, it is Rebecca Crane. I don't even... What is this? But what is this? Like, what? I don't even... What is this? What? I don't even... I know. I don't even... I was sort of stunned, actually. What? No. Hey? Oh, that's what I'm talking about right there. Do a little dance. Make a little love. Get down tonight. Okay, so according to what Outstar said before, this is what we're looking at for size. Your thoughts? Oh, man. There we go. I like it. I like it. Let's take a portrait. Wapow. The last one of the stiletto as well. All right. So, combat skills, yes. All right. So, what we're doing with this person is we want to create a character, basically, who is a... we want a character who is a hacker. And I guess I'll leave the last one to be like a sniper type. So we need someone who's basically, we can have her be like pistols and we'll do that. We'll have her be a hacker with pistols. Okay. So hacker and repair and what did we say? Hacker and repairer? Hacker and repairer. Is that right? Hacker and repairer. Is that what we said? I want to scroll up and make sure. Hacker and repairer. You want to be Russian? No, I don't want her as a sniper, though. I'm gonna make one other person as a sniper. I'm going to make one other person as a sniper. So are we talking about hacker or repairer? Like, I guess that's what we want. We want a hacker and repairer. So hack and repair. So what do I need for someone who's going to be good with hacking, repairing, and pistols? Luck 1, charisma 1. And no. She's got more charisma than that. She's got 2 charisma. She's got luck 1. That's fine. She's not that lucky. Intelligence 10? Good God, man. Strength 2. 4 points or so in core. She's not a sniper, though. That I'm just looking at what Dizzy said. You need characters that use brawling. We'll see about that. You're squatting Slav. It's basically Russian. Okay, I'll change you up to Russian then in a minute. Although, yes, it does mean something a little bit different. So she's a gun person. She's a handgun person specifically. Or I guess assault rifle. Either handgun or assault rifle is fine, but not sniper. She's not sniper. So what do we got? So what do we got? What do you guys think? If we need, like, if I increase her. I feel like she's got to have a little speed. Possibly coordination. Yeah, she's a hacker, repairer, disarmer, actually. Oh, okay. Gotcha. Make one assault rifle person. Okay, that's fine. So I'll make her an assault rifle person. That's fine. Okay, and then let's see. So we've got that. So if we're going to make her... Let's see. So if we're going to make her this, then probably everything left. What about coordination, though? Because doesn't this... Because I want her to be... Because she's got... Okay, so if she hacks and repairs... Then that means the other one can be a pick, can disarm and like lockpick. So my sniper will be my disarmer and my lockpicker. So if that's the case, so I'm not going to have her be disarming. I'm going to have my sniper person be disarming. So this person is just hacking and repairing. So this is just hacking and repairing. So for hacking and repairing, and as I said, either assault rifles or handguns, what are we looking at? Okay, perfect. So that's all I need to worry about then, is what am I doing with this? So like, is that high enough coordination? Hey, what's up, Mayo? So Outstar is going to be a hacker, a repairer, and an assault rifle slash handgun person, either one or the other. Okay, so then, like, is this good then? 10 intelligence, 5 speed, 5 coordination, 3 awareness, 2 strength, 2 charisma, 1 lore. So that'll be that. You drop 1 coordination and put it in speed, really? Well, but what about it? But I thought that you need it for the assault rifle, yeah? But I don't want to make her a 1 charisma. No, this is not my main person, though, Colton. Oh, you want to have 20 charisma in total? Well, I've got 10 charisma already. Yeah, but there's only so much that I can do about that. My main has high charisma, not intelligence. All right, so I think this is good for now. Let's take a look at the skill points. So we're going to put something in skill points. So let's do the knowledge skill here. So we said she's a hacker and a repairer. So let's put her like that. And computer science. And then we put points in I don't want her to be, she's got a good heart. She's got a good heart. I don't want to, you know, she's got a good heart. Okay, so we've got 1 assault rifle. We've got 2 computer science and 3 mechanical repair. Good. 3 mechanical repair, 2 computer science, and 1 on assault rifles. Oh, drop. Okay. So drop mechanical repair by 1. There we go. So like that, 2, 2, and 2. Oh, yeah, you might be right, actually, with intent. Oh, shoot. No, I don't remember. All right, well, let me... I'm gonna come back to this, actually. I'm going to come back to this because I don't remember if he's a repairer. I have to double check on that. Okay, let's see. Animal husbandry. No. Plus 5 skill points, 1 attribute. I've already got 1 of the trinkets thing. No. Hard ass. No. Brittle bones. No. Plus 1 skill point. Delayed gratification. No. Plus 1 to all attributes. No. Fainting goat. No. Manic depressive. No. Misophobic, no. Opportunist, no. Psychopath, no. Raised in the circus, what? Repressed rage or thick-skinned? Nah. Okay. So let me double check on this. No, he's got toaster repair. This is right. He's got toaster repair. He's got toaster repair. That's what I thought. So far so good. He's got surgeon and field medic, and she's got computer science and mechanical repair. And she's got 2 in assault rifles. So there's that. So far so good. Oh, and also I have to. Of course she's got a last name. Outstar Space Walker. Toast repair. Yeah. Okay, now the last person is going to be the sniper, lockpicker, and disarmer. Okay, so this last person is a sniper, lockpicker, and disarmer. Please don't forget that because I'm going to think about names. Sniper, lockpicker, and disarmer. Okay, now for my sniper. Let's see. Let's see. Good sniper name. Yeah, Jason Bourne. Let's see. It's going to be a male. No, it's not. It's going to be a female. And her name is going to be... 30. Religion. A Buddhist sniper. A Buddhist sniper. And she will be... Indian. To hurt anyone. Not until... came... brother away. She still never wanted. When they came to get her parents next. When they came, to finish the job, she realized everyone had to give. Never, and when more sent, find out what had happened, they discovered that the original grab team, or one bullet neatly placed in each head with a note reading instant Okay, here we go. Julia never wanted to hurt anyone. Not until the men came and took her brother away, leaving her mother and father weeping in anguish and horror on the floor. She still never wanted to hurt anyone when they came to get her parents next, calling out for her as they were dragged away. But when they came for her, to finish the job, they said, she realized that something, even her desire to be at peace with everyone, had to give. The four sent to retrieve her never reported back, and when more were sent to find out what had happened, they discovered the bodies of the original grab team lying on the floor, one bullet hole one neat bullet hole in each one's head with a note reading instant karma is gonna get you. There we go. Thank you, Morton. Okay. All right, let's customize the appearance. Okay, for her. Yeah, we want the kind of hoodie. Yes, 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 for sure. What? No, 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 no. No! The hell is this garbage? There we go. Okay, now. Goggles, probably. Yes, here we go. Torso. Needs something. Nope, 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 nope. What the hell? What? Wait a minute. What? The hell is that on her... okay, no. Oh, thanks, Outstar. I appreciate that. Oh, I do. I'll switch it. Thanks, Sharon. I'll switch it. You're right. I didn't see that. Okay, good. Packs. Let's, no. She needs something simple. Nah, she doesn't want something that weighs her down. I think that. That's not bad. I may go with that. Oh, wait. Nah, it's too restrictive. She doesn't want something like that. Yes. It's awfully brown. But I'll take it. Okay. Let's go. Nope, nope. Back up. There we go. Lovely. Although, maybe. That's more like it. There we go. Okay, she's not a giant. She's like medium. There we go. Okay, let's get rid of one of these. Lovely. Julia Deadstriker. Okay. Awesome. And change portrait. Take a snapshot. I love this feature, by the way, the take a snapshot feature. Okay. Lovely. Okay. Awesome. Cool. All right. So what did I say this person was? This person is a sniper rifle person who is also a lock picker and a disarmer. So we need someone with lock picking, disarming. Oh, wait. I already have a sniper? Did I already have a sniper? I have, Morton. In fact, I'm doing one on Saturday on my channel. I do a regular campaign. The guy who's publishing, the owner of the company who's publishing my next novel in September is Ed Greenwood, who created The Forgotten Realms. D&D is my favorite game. Okay, now, wait a minute, though. I'm going to come back to this person in just a second. Shoot. I'm going to have to come back to this person because I think I screwed this up. Did I already have a sniper rifle? You misunderstood. Okay. Yeah. All right. So 10 coordination. 10 coordination. Good God. What? Okay, one luck. No. She's got a little more luck than that. I got to roleplay it with a little more luck than that. All right. 6 awareness. I'll buy that. 2 strength. Yes, I buy that. Yeah, I did save it. I didn't lose it. I don't have a sniper. Right, this is what I'm getting right now. Okay, good. I was confused. I was like, wait, what? Okay, 5 awareness, 2 strength, 4 speed, 4 intel, 1 charisma. Man, you guys just... I'll agree on the not much charisma for her. Luck 1, charisma 1. Are you sure about that luck? Yeah. All right. I feel like I have a bunch of, like, klutzes, though. Like, they're all just not... they're all just not lucky. All right, 10 coordination, 1 luck, 6 awareness. So I need another off 2 strength, 4 speed, 4 intelligence. Like that? All right. So now we need a sniper. So this one is obvious, right? Sniper rifles. And then we want her to be able to disarm and to lockpick. So let's go with this. And... okay. I know it, Raitana. I know it. It's all raw skill. All right, what do you guys think? So what do you think? 3 sniper rifles, 2 alarm disarming, 1 lockpick. Good? Oh, wait, I need safe cracking, though. No. Don't I need safe cracking on this person? Don't I need safe cracking as well or not? Do I not need safe cracking? Okay, see you, Takanji. Do you not need safe? Do I need safe cracking or not? And no, I don't think I do have anyone with weaponsmithing, but that I can do later. I don't honestly want to build weapons if I can. 2 sniper, 2 lockpick, 2 safe cracking. 2 sniper, 2 lockpick. She's a really good sniper person, though. Okay, 2 sniper, 2 lockpick, 2 safe cracking. So not disarming? Oh, okay. Okay, gotcha. All right. Gotcha. Why can't I remove it? There we go. No, it won't let me do it. Okay, cool. Thanks, Discalti. Alright, you will need safe cracking to crack saves. So we got 2 on sniper rifles, 2 on lockpicking, but it doesn't look like I can do... Oh, yes I can. I'm an idiot. All right. Two lockpicking, two safe cracking. All right, there we go. So 10, 1, 6, 2, 4, 4, 1. And then on the combat side, we've got two sniper rifles. We've got two safe cracking, two lockpicking. Does it look good? Look good? Solid? Most impressive. Indeed, you are powerful, as the Emperor has foreseen. That kind of thing? Yeah? Okay. Now, quirk. Grew up on a farm. No. I don't want to equip trinkets. She's going to want to use trinkets. Brittle bones. What? Skill point. Each level up after level 10. I don't know that I have anyone for explosives. I have, but you know, let's see. Delayed gratification. That's no. Fading goat. I like the idea of the dysnumerophobia thing. Only because, I mean, it doesn't really matter, right? It's just a matter of getting things. I kind of like the idea that she's driven by karma in her life. I like that idea. But I don't like manic depressive, which is out of control. I don't like that. Oh, no. She's not a psychopath, but she's not a psychopath, but the opportunist thing. Oh, but negative 25% damage. No. I don't want to do that. Okay. So the only thing I'm trying to decide here is this one, which is the repressed rage thing. The 2x damage and the 25% critical chance. That's the only thing I'm not sure about. Oh, after receiving a critical hit? No. All right, here we go, people. Arvin Elleron, Doc Brown, Outstar Walker, Julia Deadstriker. All right, people. There's a problem with your party. You need perception to find secrets and mines and demolitions. Nobody has perception, so somebody's got to have perception. All right, can I drop... Who could be good in perception? She ought to have something good in perception. All right, so I need to... So I've got to do something in perception. All right, so I need something in perception. So you guys can see the statistics. Which one of these four should I drop? Should I adjust then? Like, Doc Brown has got 3 in Field Medic. Should I increase his perception? Should I drop Field Medic by a point and give him perception? I mean, Julia Deadstriker would be the one who, like, RPG-wise... Yeah, I didn't want to fiddle with it too much. So can I drop her, if I drop her to lockpicking, if I drop her in lockpicking, okay, I'm gonna give him 1 perception, so I'm gonna drop Field Medic down, I'm gonna give him 1 in perception, alright, so I've got him there, so I've got 1 in perception for him, then, okay, that's fine. And then Julia Deadstriker, RPG-wise, which one can I get rid of? Can I get rid of lockpicking? Like, not get rid of it, but drop down. Can I drop down lockpicking or drop down safecracking? I can probably drop down safecracking 1, right? Or no? Can I drop down safecracking or lockpicking? Which one of these two should I drop? And then I'm going to add perception for her. Because it makes sense that she would have that perception RPG-wise. And then I just have to figure out demolitions, but I'll figure that out in a second. So, safe cracking or lockpicking? What do you guys think? I'll drop one of those down. Safe cracking. I feel like safe cracking is going to be not as important. Okay. And point in perception. Okay. All right, that takes care of that. Now we just need one in demolitions. So let's see, who's going to be the demolitions expert? I feel like Outstar Walker would be the most likely to be a demolitions expert. So I just need, so do I need someone with demolitions? Because if so, I'll make it Outstar Walker, and then we're going to move on. Oh, yeah? Yeah, but, I mean, but the thing is, though, his whole thing is that he's Mr. Charismatic, though, RP-wise. Like, RP-wise, he's only one character need perception. I thought both of them did, no? Because then he's going to be the demolitions guy because he's Doc Brown. So if only one of them needs perception, then he's going to be the guy that I'm going to give explosives to. Or demolitions to, rather. All right. Okay. So what do you think about this? So she's got perception. He's got demolitions. So there we go. Viable? Good? Hey, DJ Tracy. All right, good. This isn't going to break the game in 2 seconds. I don't mind if it's not, you know, the easiest way. I just don't want this to be a party that can't function at all. So that's good. All right. Let's do it, people. Let's make it happen. I'm going to move this back over here. And let's do it up. Drop field medic to 1. Why? Okay. That's fair enough. Okay. Doc Brown the badass. Okay, let's do it. Okay, always seasoned. I always try to do normal, basically, which is the equivalent. Had some experience, the waste or places like it, you know which end of the Mason cannon to point at the enemy. This is the setting for you. Oh, I have to make one adjustment on his biography. And a seriously badass sword. A seriously sword, yes. There we go. Awesome, let's do it. Here we go. I'll do what I can, Outstar. I'll do what I can. Sleep well. A little loud, I know. I'll fix it later. Movie is super loud. I see that. The only thing necessary for the triumph of evil is that good men do nothing. General Vargas.
What comes after the end? I don't know. Neither did they. They were just an army engineer battalion, constructing roads and bridges deep in the middle of the Arizona nowhere. They didn't know why Armageddon had come. They'd heard radio chatter about an attack on some space-based missile platform. But who had attacked it, or why? No one knew. What they did know is that the politicians and the generals had finally ended the world. Now, everything was gone. They took over a federal prison for a fort, kicked out the convicts, got busy starting from scratch. Maybe it was an act of mercy. Maybe they figured that the prisoners would die out in the harsh new world. Whichever, it came back to bite the engineers in the ass. Cultists, criminals, cannibals. They've been living with the fallout ever since. Good people had survived too, called for help in the night. And those engineers, those common soldiers, could not stand by and see them die. So they came out of their fort, and they helped the survivors defend their homes. And for that, they earned a new name, a proud name, the Desert Rangers. Now, Rangers, I know at times it seems our cause is hopeless.
Okay, I should be back. Let me know if that's better. I should be back now. I had to switch. I had to switch servers. Yeah, Twitch has been having issues lately. I don't know what's been going on with them, but over the last week, week and a half, I've had to switch. Usually every few days, I've had to switch from Virginia to New York to New York back to Virginia. So, yeah, that was the game. Yeah, exactly. So is that okay? Can everyone, is it back now? No buffering? I had to switch servers. I'm still getting a little bit of it, though. I don't know what's going on with the servers tonight. My internet is fine. How are we looking now, guys? How are we looking now? Test one, test two. Okay. Well, now I'm not dropping frames now, so I'm trying again. Yeah, okay. Well, knock on wood, guys. Okay, I switched back over to I switched back over. Yeah, I'm not dropping frames now. I switched to Chicago now. I mean, listen, I as I said, I have 50 download and 27 up, so this is or no, actually, I'm sorry. That's not true. 30 up. So I have 50 down and 30 up. So this is not on my end, I'm afraid. But yeah, sorry. So if you're still getting bad connections, I would suggest refreshing because I'm not dropping on my end now. So okay, sorry guys. Normally I have as I say, my internet's very stable, but this is not on my end that this is happening. So sorry guys. Okay, where were we? We were watching this stuff. Chicago Hope. Yep, Chicago Hope. That's right. New York City. New York City, dear one. And I paid for a little bit extra so I could get the higher upload. So, all right, here we go. Yeah, actually, that's a good point. That's a good call. Let me just quickly do a quick delay test. Please type in when you see this, when you hear this, please type in the word phone. Phone, as in cell phone. Phone. And I'm going to count how long it takes. I just want to do a quick test. Okay, that's about 11 seconds. All right, thanks, guys. Awesome. Okay, so that's about 11 seconds. Kristen's a nice. Cool. All right, nice. Excellent. All right, that's about 11 second delay. That's about standard. Okay. All right, thanks, guys. Sorry about that. And when you see the VOD, this is actually not, I always record my stuff locally and then upload it as one file to YouTube. So you're not going to have to watch like five different attempts. But apologies. So keep your fingers crossed on this other stuff. All right, back into the video. Let's do it.
And I know it's hard to say goodbye to a brother in arms. But I want you to know something else, that no Ranger who dies in the line of duty will ever be forgotten. Nor will he have ever died in vain or unavenged.
Born a man, died a desert ranger. Aha!
Recruits.
Zoom out. Here we go. A stiff, bearded older man wearing a hard-worn ranger uniform and a battered old cowboy hat. General Vargas walks with a cane, but he's not helpless. He wears a pearl-handed revolver on his hip, and there are a lot of notches on the barrel.
I appreciate you coming to Captain Ace's retirement party when you hardly knew the man. Appropriate, too, seeing as how investigating his death will be your first duty as a desert ranger.
Okay, before I go on...
Are you walking away from me, recruits?
Wait.
I'm not done too much better. Now your mission is this. Search the area where Ace's
okay,
body
I'm gonna have to wait. I was trying to fix your sound, you jackass.
And the repeater units. Then radio
I know
in
it's quiet.
Report. If the repeaters are in good working order,
hello,
not a
username.
Send you on to finish his mission.
Okay, so you're gonna have to give me a second because apparently I'm not allowed to change options because clown face here is gonna be mad.
I know you're gonna be tempted to hunt for Ace's murderers along the way, and if you find them, good. But your priority, however, is finding that signal. Vengeance for Ace's death is not as important as assessing this threat to our security.
Is this guy, is this loud enough, by the way, guys, or is it quiet? It's presumably quiet, right? Is it quiet for you guys, his voice acting? Because it just means I'll have to adjust the audio when I get out of this, interaction. So, quiet or not quiet? It's fairly quiet. Okay, that's what I thought. Okay, I'll up it up. How did Ace die, sir?
Ace had been trying to locate a faint radio signal, which has lately been giving us cause for concern. We gave him 3 repeater units and sent him to hook him up to 3 remote radio towers. This would have allowed us to get a fix on the signal. But sadly, Ace was murdered by unknown assailants right after hooking up the first tower.
Okay.
And his logbook and the last 2 repeater units were stolen.
All right, I'll fix that.
Yeah, I know. You've hardly found your feet with us, and here I am sending you on a mission that already got 1 ranger killed. Well, I wish I had another option, but the Desert Rangers are spread a little thin right now. Ranger teams Abel and Charlie are out west trying to stop a range war out there from becoming straight-up genocide, and Team Baker is up north looking for a way through the radiation that's cut us off from Vegas. I'm afraid the next generation is going to have to lead the charge on this one.
Where is this area, sir?
It's about a day's walk east from here. I'll mark it on your map.
Wow. Oh, yeah, certainly George could. So could Trendane, for that matter. But yeah, George absolutely could.
There you go.
There you go. Let's see. You think the logbook was stolen, sir?
Don't know, but it wasn't on Ace's person when he was found. Look for it. It might have some clues as to his death.
What about these repeater units, sir?
When you get back to the Citadel, talk to our radio expert, Wade Woodson, if you want to know more about the technical details.
Wade Woodson, backup quarterback for the Vikings?
The repeaters will upgrade the towers and allow us to zero in on the mystery signal.
The signal's a threat, sir?
The voice on those broadcasts disturbed me greatly. It talked crazy talk about a future where man and machine would be one. Worse, it talked about us, the Desert Rangers, specifically. It said it was coming for us.
Where are the radio towers?
I'll give you the locations of the towers once you have the repeaters in hand. More important to find them first.
God damn it. I said, where are the... Okay. What's the mission, sir?
The mission is this. Search the area where Ace's body was found, and do your best to recover his logbook and the repeater units. Then call in your report. If you find the repeaters, I may send you on to finish his mission. Ace's death must be avenged, and it will be. But finding the signal he died trying to track down is just as important. Besides, I got the sneaking suspicion that when you find the one, you'll find the other.
Call in?
Yes, call in on your radio. Your radio is your lifeline to Ranger Citadel. We'll be calling you with alerts and updates on your current missions.
Exactly.
And sending you new missions when we receive distress calls. As Rangers, it is your sworn duty to respond to those calls. That is the contract we made with the people of Arizona when we opened for business.
Sir, I'm going to ask you a bunch of newbie questions that I clearly already know for the benefit of Twitch chat. So, when can we enter the Citadel, sir?
Once you prove yourself, the Citadel will be your new home. Consider this mission the final test of your training. If you succeed, you are welcome within our walls. If you fail, then you aren't cut out to be a Desert Ranger, and we won't let you in.
Surely, sir, the success of the mission is more important than testing us. If you want to find these signals, shouldn't you let us in so we can stock up on everything we need to succeed?
Using logic on me, eh? Smartass. Logic and observation will change some folks' minds, and you can catch people in lies that way. But sometime, it only makes them mad. So be careful. In this case, you're right.
Hell yeah.
I should let you in. But I got a feeling about you four. You got depths you don't even know you have. And it's going to take adversity to tap them. So I'm sending you out undergunned and unprepared, just to see what it brings out of you. You'll thank me later.
No, I won't, you piece of crap.
Maybe.
Thank you, sir. We'll do our best.
Good luck out there, recruits.
Okay. So now, let's get some, let's change the options up a little bit. Let's turn this global ob up a bit. A little more on that. Okay. There we go. Alright. Yeah, total pro. That's what I'm all about, being a total pro. All right, so here we go. How do I... All right, so I swing it around this way. Swing around this way. Pick up that shovel. Here lies Ace, born a man, died a desert ranger.
Why are you still here, recruits? I get good luck out there, recruits.
Okay. Here we've got a map. All right, we got a citadel entrance. All right, so let's see what we get down this way, shall we? Is that a level up? Arvin was the first name, yeah. Law book, using items. Find many items in the wasteland, some of which could be used in the game world. To use these, either open your inventory, right-click on the item, select the use button assigned to your hotbar. Most items can only be used on certain objects or characters. All right. And logbook is your guide to the missions, notes and other information, blah, blah, blah. Paste two tabs in your progress. All right. Seems logical. Can I? Okay, good. Actually, what I should probably do... allows me to switch up characters. Okay. I assume F5 is quick save. Maybe not. I actually want to save it under something else, though. So we're gonna... This is the one that I played before. So we're gonna do... that. Oh, okay. That works. Lovely. Alright. Yeah, what is the key for being able to see everything? Is it... ah! I don't know what that just was. What's the key for being... is it Alt? What's the key for being able to see everything that's on the ground? That's a good question. Is it Alt? That's the Citadel, I think. Good to see you, recruits. Afraid I can't open this door for you yet. Oh, cool. Welcome in then, DJ. Okay. A desert ranger in scarred but spotless combat armor stands at attention before the doors of the Ranger's Citadel. He gives you a friendly salute. Welcome to Ranger's Citadel, recruits, but the general ordered me not to let you in before you finished your first investigation. Alright, I'm not going to try to push that. Switch on perception on the guy gal that has it. Perception, I think, is her. Okay. Oh, and activate it? Oh, okay. There we go. Thank you. All right, let's see what we got. What is this GOG channel, Miranda? This is related to the what used to be called Good Old Games is now just called GOG or GOG. That does is a really good company that releases a lot of DRM-free games. Is a public, basically distributes a lot of DRM-free games. Really, really nice people. And the GOG stream team, which is myself and about 20-plus other people, led by our fearless stream team leader, Outstar Walker, streams a bunch of shows. Most of us have our own individual channels as well, as I do. And I stream here once a week on Tuesday nights from 7 p.m. Eastern to 10 p.m. Eastern with a show called Pen and Pixels, which focuses on games that have a lot of story and narrative foundations to them. And that's what that's about. Okay, let's see. It's always active, activating unless there's rain. Okay. Howdy there, Team Echo. Oh no, kindly old woman in standard issue ranger garb seems occupied counting goods and organizing crates. Aside from the clothes, she's the picture of a loving grandmother. You could smell she smells faintly of fresh baked cookies. Well, hello, recruits. Welcome to Solvike Sundries. I'm happy to trade whenever you like, and honor to make your acquaintance. Always nice to see new faces around here, and a pleasure to make sure they have everything they need before they head out into the big bad world. Nice to meet you too, Solvike. What's your story? Oh, it's not so interesting. I grew up in... Oh, it's Z. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. I grew up in a village near here, but I was already a grandmother twice over when the Desert Rangers moved into the Citadel. I saw how much good the Rangers were doing, and I wasn't up to much with my children moved to other villages to start their own families. It was a little unconventional for an old lady to go through basic training, but I pulled my weight and earned my star. I may not be too useful in forward operations, but I've got lots of experience keeping people well-fed and well-clothed. And I can run a drill press with the best of them. So General Vargas has me try to help Sergeant Melson run the supply. And I help Captain Mercaptain in the workshop now and again. His name is Captain Mercaptain? Really? What's Captain Mercaptain like, other than redundant? She's the smartest person I've ever met, bar none. She could whip up laser beams and water purification systems like I whip up pies. Like, you know, Mega Pie Man, PhDs. Like that. What's Sergeant Melson like? Oh, he's a great friend and a great quartermaster. We'd all be eating sand and wiping with cactus flowers without him. Oh, boy. What's General Vargas like? He's a modern-day Patton. He's got a mind for strategy and knows how to make the tough calls. But he's got a gentle side, too. The Ranger Citadel? What about it? I do love this place nowadays. It used to be full of some kooky birds when I was younger. Fellas seemed to worship pre-war junk, even if they didn't know what it was, and they wouldn't share none of it. Well, I shouldn't get too judgmental. I'm sure they thought they were doing right. I want to be like, I asked about the Ranger Citadel, ma'am. Sorry, love, can't say I know about that. Okay. So you can outfit us? Well, with essentials as tough to find as they are, I can't just give them away for free. Oh, believe me, I wish I could. But we keep our prices as close to cost as we can for our rangers. You can stop by for the basics whenever you're in the area. And once you get clearance to enter the Citadel, you'll get access to some of my more valuable goodies. You'll have to talk to Sergeant Melson about that when you get inside. What do you have to trade? Okay, barter. What have we got? We have got 50 scrap. Goat hide armor. I bet all of this is not going to be... You get a figurine? No. This is the part, like, when, you know, you go to the carnival and you play all day, but you don't do very well at the games, and so all you basically have are just, like, a couple of tickets at the very end, and you're like, I guess I could get that terrible cheap sticker, you know, and you feel like you want to get something. Okay, none of this is worth getting. Can I sell anything? Low-dosage pain relievers or a shovel. I'm not getting rid of that. See ya. Okay. To rotate the camera, you press Q and E, or press and hold the middle mouse button. Okay. Pan the camera. Alright. Zoom. Okay, that's all pretty much what I already assumed. To use an active skill, assign to the hotbar by right-clicking an empty slot, left-clicking the one you want to put in that skill, left-click the skills icon to activate it, left-click an object character to use it, you can right-click on a valid object or character to see a pop-up showing all available skill options. Okay. Alright. Goodbye. Lovely to meet you, Team Echo. Come back again real soon. Alright. Z. There we go.
Mind picking up that can over there for me? Think there's some water in there.
The hell was that goat? That's funny. That's a little inside reference. That's good stuff. That's good stuff. I like it. That is good stuff. Hey, hon. What? Yeah. Oh, they did? Oh, good. About time. Yeah, exactly, Cloud Kingdom. I knew you were trouble when you walked in. All right. So what does he want me to do? He wants me to pick up a can or something? Oh, this thing. Hey!
He headbutted you right in the butt.
Someone should be able to find you a link to the reference. There's a YouTube video that has the screaming goat. That is Mrs. Elleron, yes. Okay. Hey, smart guy.
Did you actually think I was serious about wanting that can? I just wanted the goat to hit you in the ass.
That's hilarious. Just about as hilarious is going to be what happens when I pound you in the face, no? Okay, so you guys are just a bunch of bros. Just a bunch of bros. Oh wait, there's a water source. It's the screaming goat. I'm screaming on the cold, cold ground. Ah! Ah! Trouble, trouble, trouble. Oh, man. All right, let's see. We got Tense. We got Angela Death. All right, let's go meet up with Angela Death. Because her name is Angela Death. So quite obviously. Oh, actually, you know what? Now that I'm looking at this, I see that probably I ought to move this, I think, over here. And let's put me here. Actually, no. We're going to put... Well, yeah. I guess so. We'll put my logo. We're going to put this like that. We're going to put this up here. That's better. That way you guys can actually see what's going on. Okay. What's going on? Oh, wait a second, wait a second, wait a second. Wait a second, wait a second. So, let's put the... No, that's not what I meant to do. Add to hotkey. Aha! We got some scrap, we got an energy cell, we got a deck of cards. That's what I'm talking about, people. Scrap's currency used in the wasteland. No maximum limit to how much scrap your party can carry. Doesn't weigh anything. Okay.
God damn it, Ace. You never should have put down the wrench and picked up the gun.
Oh, Angela Death. What's up, lady?
Sorry about the waterworks. I'm still pretty broke up over Ace. I'm Angie. You kids must be the new recruits old Vargas trained up. Lord, y'all just babies.
Yeah, well, that's what I was basically doing. I'll try moving... Actually, I'll do one other thing, which is I'll try moving this like that. I'll move this up here. I'll move this up here. And I'll move my logo right here. No, I'll move my logo... let's move this down this. Lord, y'all just babies. Lord, Lord, Lord. Get that all the time, lady. All right. Babies? Us?
Sorry, but you are. As cute as little kittens. Y'all remind me of us. Snake, Razor, Thrasher, and me. Back when we were just starting out. thinking we were gonna save the world for the future. Thinking none of us would ever die. Christ, sorry. Don't listen to me. Youth is good. Optimism is good. If we all started out worn out and jaded like me, nobody'd ever try to change the world. So you kids go ahead and give it a go. Maybe it'll work this time.
We saw you at Ace's funeral. You knew him well?
They all hurt, but this one... Man, Ace wasn't even a ranger. Not at first. He worked as a driver and mechanic for Farron Brigo up in Vegas. When Base Cochise started sending its death machines into the desert, Brigo sent Ace south to recruit robot fighters. We met him in Quartz. He'd pissed somebody off out there and they'd locked him up. We sorted that out, and he started running with us, helping us fight Cochise. Never stopped. Vargas eventually gave him the uniform and the hat, but I don't think he ever formally signed on. He was just always there. And now he's... God damn it, Ace. I knew this one was trouble. I knew it.
You thought Ace's mission was trouble?
He was working on the same thing Vargas has you working on. Trying to track down radio signals from beyond the edges of the map. All seemed a bit boring and scientific to me. But then Ace started saying he thought someone was following him. I asked him to let me come with him when I met him at Rail Nomads to give him the repeater units. But he told me to go back to base. He said he was just jumping at shadows because those radio broadcasts had spooked him. Should have gone with him. Why didn't I go with him?
Have you heard any of these strange broadcasts?
Ace played me some of them before he died. Hard to make out a lot of it, but what I heard made my hair stand on end. Some guy talking about turning men into machines, or machines into men, or some shit. But the crazy thing was, then he starts talking about us, the Rangers, saying we're the cause of all the trouble in the world, and we need to be wiped out so his glorious future can be born. I mean, who is this guy? Where is he? What the fuck does he have against us?
You know any more about these repeater units?
I don't really know the details. It's all a bunch of mumbo-jumbo about transmitters and north-south axis and signals bouncing off the clouds. Ask Woodson about it. He's our radio genius.
You know Woodson?
Radio technician Wade Woodson?
The backup quarterback for the Vikings?
He's the guy that makes sure you can hear Vargas when you're out on patrol. Keeps the machines running and the signal clear. He'll also talk your ear off about circuits and frequencies and I don't know what else if you let him. But be nice to him. He's your lifeline to the base.
Tell me about the Rail Nomads.
Could be a nice little place if the Atchisons and Topekans would kiss and make up. I can't even remember what it's all about. But between them, they got enough old railroad tech that if they worked together, they could give this area a real transportation system. Instead, seems like all they want to do is blow each other's heads off. Idiots.
See, Inquisitor. Nightman. The man. Machine. Where's Quartz?
Man, not sure I can recall. Haven't been out that way in ages. Don't even know if it's still on the map. Ask Thrasher. He'd know.
Where's Thrasher now?
You better call him Gilbert now. Funny.
Okay.
Back in the day, he just seemed like this big old growly bear. Strong as an ox and just about as articulate. But then he got all torn up during our fight with the robots from Base Cochise. And he couldn't go out on patrol no more.
And he would look at people and he'd go, I don't understand why I'm expected to fight. He became Gilbert Gottfried.
Any other commander would have handed him his walking papers. But Vargas doesn't dump old friends. So he started him working in the museum. And once you know it, turns out the old bear has a knack for cartography. He's been gradually mapping our little corner of the wasteland ever since. Who'd have thunk it?
Well, what was Base Cochise?
An old military facility from before the war. And the biggest fight the Rangers ever had. There was some crazy computer in there that kept spitting out robots and sending them off to kill people. We had one hell of a fight putting it down. Earned our stripes that day. Literally. That's when I became Captain Death.
A computer was making the robots?
Yeah. The Base Cochise AI. Don't know what was wrong with it. Broken, I guess. It thought everybody was its enemy. Wanted to kill the whole planet.
Ma'am, was its name Skynet? Oh. What happened to Hellraiser?
One gone. Went out for a patrol a few weeks back and never came home. Don't know if he's dead or AWOL. We're gone off to join the Scorpions.
The Scorpions?
All anybody knows is he hasn't called in, and we haven't heard from anybody who's seen him.
Here I am. Rock you like a hurricane.
I miss old Hellraiser like blazes. Didn't talk much. Didn't make friends easy. Wasn't big on social graces. But he was as loyal as they come. And when the shit started flying, he was the guy you wanted at your back. He didn't win that name by accident. Sharp as a razor. Scary as hell.
The Red Scorpions with a K?
You weren't briefed on those fucks during your training? Well, let me fill you in. You know when we left the prison and moved here to the Citadel? Well, the Scorpions were the jerks who moved into the prison when we moved out. Just a bunch of rangers back then, but they
rangers.
Didn't get more organized. Call themselves a militia now, and they try to act like they're the Desert Rangers of Eastern Arizona.
Ma'am, I do believe you've messed up your voice acting. It's a bunch of raiders.
This protection racket ain't the same as protecting people. They shake down all their towns for money, and if the locals don't kick in, they smash them up. The rangers aren't like that. We get by on donations and good old-fashioned scavenging.
And mixing up raiders for rangers. What can you tell us about Eastern Arizona?
Basically everything between the prison and the radiation clouds to the east. There are a few small towns and farms out there, which the Scorpions claim is their territory. Rangers used to patrol that area before we moved here, and we knew it pretty well. But a lot can change in 15 years. Who knows? Maybe it's all as clean and nice and crime-free as the Scorpions say it is. But I've got my doubts.
Radiation clouds?
The edges of the map, kiddies. Big hot areas we can't get into without getting cooked to a crisp. The clouds move around some with the wind and the weather, but there are permanent hot spots on every side of us. North, south, east, and west. Until we started hearing those weird broadcasts, I kind of thought those clouds went on forever. And that Arizona was the last place on Earth. But maybe there's more people out there. Maybe the whole rest of the world's just fine, and we're the only ones in hell. Wouldn't that be a joke?
So General Vargas used to be called Snake. Did he do a lot of things like this? No, I can't believe I'm sending you out there. No, I'm telling you not to. Who is this? Otacon, why are you...
Yep, he was one wild-ass son of a bitch back in the day. But I think the weight of his responsibilities has kind of squashed that out of him now. He hasn't been in a decent bar fight in, shit, a decade, maybe?
How well do you know General Vargas?
Better than he'd like.
That's
Back
fair,
in the
gross.
Day, the General was the craziest of us all. But somehow, after he brought down Base Cochise, he became the sanest. Now he's running the whole show and doing a damn fine job. Well, I'm still walking patrols and answering radio calls. Shows you how much ambition I got, huh?
All right, goodbye.
Say, listen. Vargas asked you to look into Ace's death because he thought I was too upset to be professional about it. He didn't want me going off half-cocked and shooting up all of Arizona looking for his killer. But I gotta find this guy. Ace and me, well, we'd been fighting side by side for nigh on 20 years. I'm not letting him die unavenged. So, well, I know it's going against orders, but if you let me tag along and be in at the kill, well, I'll help you find your feet out there. Maybe give you a few pointers along the way. I may be old and slow, but I know the wastes like the back of my hand. What do you say?
Sure. Yeah, we got us an NPC.
No need to tell Vargas why I joined you. If anybody asks, I'm just helping you get oriented, all right?
During your travels, come across people willing to join your squads. Controlled and customized just like your own ranger recruits you start the game with. They have personalities and characteristics of their own. Alright. Cool. Alright, well, let's save it. Okay. Let's do it. Right, so... I think we've just about found almost everything we need. Aberfort. Who are all these people? So we're gonna find out. Oh yeah, these jackasses. Okay, let's dig that up and see what we got. Yeah, I did. I did. Scorched snuff box. There you go, that's Z. A glass eye, 38 caliber ammo, that's cool, and scrap. Oh wait, I should be distributing it all, shouldn't I? I should be distributing that all. Pistols, revolvers, and SMGs. Who the hell is the... Who's SMGs? I don't think I have anything with any of those, actually. Unless she does. No, she doesn't. Okay. Alright. Let's talk to Ranger Brass Knucks.
Sorry, can't talk right now. Gotta clean up this graffiti.
Yeah, I know. I already noticed that, Drake. I already ran afoul of the goat. And the goat will pay with his life! Okay. Let's save this first. And then... What is the quick save? There should be a quick save, right? Save that. Is there a quick save? Let's see if I want to find what that quick save is. F9. All right. Lovely. Let's do that then. Quick save, F9. Yeah, it's not, I know, it's not F5, I tried that already. Aha. Brute force, no. Let's try lockpick. Oh, perception. Oh, I find a lock. Lovely. Do it, Julia. Hell yeah. What else we got here? Oops, wait. Pre-war ammo can? Nice. Let's distribute that. Heavy plastic latches, alright. Ho-ho! A sawed-off shotgun! Ladies and gentlemen, all right, let's see whether that's better than the one he's already got. He's got a pump shotgun, 5 AP. That, well, the range is less. It's only got a 2-round capacity. That's better, though. Cool. All right, wonderful. That works. Nice. Okay, cool. So, now that we got this. Well, Wasteland 1 was the original, Mirinda. Wasteland 1 came out before Fallout. And so you could argue that Fallout was really kind of a riff off Wasteland. Wasteland 2 came out in, I think, 2013, I want to say. I actually know... Actually, ironically, you guys will appreciate this, I think. My graphic novel, Icarus, is coming out. It looks like now it's going to be coming out in early March in digital form. And then the physical release will be, the physical book release will be a month later in early April. One of the guys who's writing a short story that's going to be included, like a short graphic part, basically, that's going to be included in the graphic novel is a guy named Mike Stackpole, who's well known for things like he wrote the book Rogue Squadron. And stuff like that. But Mike also was one of the original writers on Wasteland 1, which is how I first heard about Wasteland 1 and Wasteland 2 was back about that. So, yeah. Not really, Mubot? Oh, yeah. Thematically, for sure. Gameplay, probably. I mean, I have played Fallout 1. I gave up on it about 6 hours in, got really annoyed with Fallout for reasons I won't get into right now. But possibly. I mean, I don't know because I haven't played this long enough to really make the comparison. But all right, I think we're good to go. So it's time to head out into the wilderness. So let's do this. Yes. Turn the game. Let's do it.
Ranger Team Echo, this is Ranger Command. Come in.
This is Ranger Team Echo. Wait. This is Ranger Team Echo?
Roger, Echo One. Just making sure your radio is working. I'll be your dispatcher from here on out. I also wanted to give you a little heads up on your water situation. If you've all got full canteens,
hey, Rogan.
You should have enough water to reach the place where Ace died with plenty to spare. But if you're going to go exploring, you'll want to fill up again at any oasis you can find.
Yeah, the problem I had with that is, number one, I generally don't like post-apocalyptic settings. There's only a couple of exceptions to that, very few exceptions to it, and I'm hoping this will be one of them. I've heard so many good things about this that I decided I wanted to give it a whirl, but generally post-apocalyptic settings tend not to be my thing. The other thing is that for Fallout 1, the RNG absolutely pissed me off. I created in Fallout 1 a guy who was a world-class gun expert. Like, I poured all these points into his gun skills. And I was standing next to a guy who was literally stunned and unconscious on the ground. I had a 99% chance to hit him at point-blank range and missed. And I was like, yep, click, uninstall, never playing this again. I was like, no. If you are a world-class marksman, you will never miss someone, ever, who is unconscious and stunned as you are standing right next to them. It will not happen. So, God. And it was just sort of symptomatic of other problems that I had with the combat system. So, Fallout 1 and I did not get along. Ugh, RNG. I don't mind RNG. I mind it when it becomes... There should have been no RNG. It just doesn't... No. Okay. So, but it's cool if you like it, Dayroin. Everyone can like different things.
Remember, your main priority is to recover the repeater units Ace was carrying. Once you've got the devices, you'll be headed to Ag Center and Highpool to install them. But we'll talk about that after you acquire the repeaters. We must, of course, bring Ace's killers to justice. But right now, that's secondary to discovering the location of that signal.
Exactly, Rogan. Does that mean you weren't always the dispatcher?
Until now, Woodson's been our dispatcher. But Ace's death made me realize I've spent too many years in my office, walled off from the world and how it's changing. I need to know what's going on out there, and I figure the best way to do that is to start listening to the people's problems. So, I've decided that from now on, I'll be the one fielding calls and talking in your ear when you head out into the wastes. Don't let that make you self-conscious or nothing.
Oh no, hell no. So it's important to stay in radio contact with you?
It is vital that all teams stay in radio contact with me here at the base. We get distress calls from all over our jurisdiction.
Distress?
And sometimes beyond. Towns or farms or mines being attacked by raiders, mutant beasts, what have you. We field those calls here and then dispatch whichever team is closest to the problem.
Roger, out.
10-4 Echo 1, carry on. Ranger Command out.
Okay, blah, 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 blah. Calls from the Wasteland inhabitants. Call button on the radio to contact. Headquarters earn field promotions. Oh, okay, that's cool. Leave those cannons. Right-click and light to travel. Access the world map screen. Fair, okay, fine. You can stumble upon friendly enemy random encounters. Hidden loot caches. Okay. And the outdoorsman skill determines your squad's search radius in the world map and traveling, as well as its ability to avoid hostile random encounters. So, oh my God, it's a moving badge. Dun 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 dun. Let's run. Oh God. 75% chance. Nope, fail. Well, all right. I guess this is a chance to kind of see what we got for combat. What do we got here? Oh, they're the Raiders. How many Raiders we got? Oh, okay. So they haven't spotted me yet. So, let's see. Shoot. Well, darn it. That's right, you missed.
Baby. I'm playing a game that you probably can't watch. Yeah, they're attacking. No, there's four. There's actually five. There's her, and then there's her, and then there's three others.
This is my daughter that I'm talking to, by the way. Yeah, those are my guys over there in the white circles, and then I've got the Raider. That's one guy who's attacking me there in the red circle, who I'm going to have to deal with. Yeah, I know. I kind of messed it up, Coulson. It looks to me like it's, like, raining. It looks like rain. This is in the desert, so I'm, or like, Arizona, so I'm pretty sure. That's just like clouds. Like, you know how clouds of rain when the wind blows? You can see like rain, like clouds of rain. It looks almost like sheets blowing. That's what that is. Thank you. I'll let you know if I do. I love you. Sorry about that, folks, but well, yeah, she's the best. My daughter is awesome. But she's 8 years old, and this would not be appropriate. Hold on, I'm going to close the door. Ugh. There we go. Hey, Wolf Boy. Yeah, sorry about that, guys. But she does know. She likes... I do share some of the stuff that I play with her, but a game like this, not so much. All right. So, let's see. The logical thing to do is not have her up close and personal. If I can tell. Alright, let's go back to this guy and see what we can deal with first. Am I not able to... Oh, it's still her? Shoot, how do I switch back? Oh, because she gets initiative. I see. Alright, AP. I'm gonna have how much left? I have 6 AP. Hope I don't get... Okay, good. So it's 2 AP. Now... Precision strike. Julia Deathstrike, ladies and gentlemen, Julia Deathstriker, Julia Deathstriker. All right, let's see. Wow, can I get over here? I can't. Can I? My goodness, that's crazy. All right, let's get over here into cover. I know. No, I know it, like, 30%. Oh, I can't... So okay, so... I think ambush means that if someone comes within range, then I attack them. I'm hoping that's what that means, but if not, then I'm about to find out. Let's get physical. Let's move somewhere better than this. If I can get... Let's do it. It means Overwatch? Okay, that's what I thought. That's what I thought. I figured as much. Let's see. Do AP points carry over? Or do AP cover over? Okay, that's what I figured. That's what I figured. Does AP cover over, do you guys know? Or AP cover over. Does AP carry over or not? Do you guys know? It does? Okay. Good then. Ah, Julia Deadstriker, we're gonna get along so well. Ow! That hurt. Okay, let's see. Oh, nice. Okay, 6% chance to hit. No. 36. Okay. Really? 36% chance. All right, well, the hell with the called shot. Wow. Brutal. Brutal technique. It carries up to 2 AP. All right. I do not like being way out of cover here, but this she's going to get a chance to go next. I'm going to back up one step. All right. 6%. Actually, that crowns my field medic, right? All right. Let's put her on Overwatch. Man, I wish there was another spot where I could put her on Overwatch. Wow. Brutal. All right.
Watch how it's done.
Really? Watch how it's done? Interesting. So there's times. Sorry. Hold on. I'm getting rid of something. So there's times when they'll just ignore you, huh? Really. Nice work, Angela. So far, what I've done is actually have my other guys have, like, been super successful, and you have been a complete abject failure. So... let's kind of keep that in mind. All right. Put you in ambush mode. Okay. I want to see if I can... I'm out of combat. He's probably all right for now. So, Book of Eli, yep. Yeah, that's interesting. Okay, so I have good leadership skills. So that's, like, interesting. Anyway, we're gonna ambush this guy on so much with the ambush. I don't like where he's positioned, so I'm gonna put him here. And I'm gonna end, well, it's probably unnecessary to ambush, but. Nice. Well done, team. Nice. What do you mean? What are you talking about? Okay, that's what loot is. I think I know what loot is. I know what loot containers are, yes. That is good to know that they could be trapped, though. Energy weapons don't use armor penetration. Conductive armor, okay. Or penetration. Certain weapons are more effective against armor than others. I already know about that. Precision strikes lay to target individual body parts and enemies to inflict debilitating effects at the cost of a lower chance to hit. Okay. Got a lot of stuff to look at here. Let's see. Action queue shows the turn order for combat. Combat initiative stat. Higher the combat initiative. Okay, that's fine. Cover. I think I know cover plays a vital role. All right, that's pretty obvious. Action points. Measurement how many things a ranger can do each turn while in combat. Not all characters have the same amount of AP. Certain actions take different numbers in AP for different characters. Okay. Once all characters' AP is used, you can carry over to 2 bonus AP. And combat. Okay, I think I've just learned what combat is. All right. Let's see. So, can you restore health? And actually, let me save. What? You can't save it this time. I'm not in combat. Can you restore health? Is the only way to restore health by using consumables? Okay, that's good to know, Dizzy. No, the one who executed the ambush and took all the enemy's health, Mirindo, was my person, Julia. Julia, that would be Julia Deadstriker, who freaking destroyed them. Notice Angela Death? Miss. Let's take a look at how Julia Deadstriker did her stuff. 27 points of damage. 10 points of damage. Julia Deadstriker was ridiculous. Angela Death was like, miss. You can't save on random counter maps. So for healing, though, is there like a rest command or something like that? Or like what is involved with that? Anti-venom. Compact mirror. Library card. Oh, that's all of the dead guys? Yeah, never mind. Now you have to heal manually. Okay. So, like, even if they sleep, they don't get any health back. Do they ever get health back over time? Or the only way they get health back is with consumables? Where did Angela Death get a hit? Oh, yeah, she did. I'm sorry. She did do damage once. She got 10 points of damage. But still, telling me, like, let me show you how it's done. When she just watched my sniper freaking tear up these... And Arvin freaking hit him, too. Nice work with intent. What, Wolf Boy? Consumables are going to a special NPC. All right. Well, 23 out of 32. Okay, well, let's take a look at how many of these he's got. So he's got Pocket Medic Pack. There's 25 to 35 points. Here's 12 points. Nice. Okay. Lovely. All right. Oh, God. Keep forgetting I can't do that. All right. So let's get out of these areas then. Actually, how do I... Oh, there's the travel. No. I don't want to use the demolition skill. Thanks. Yeah, exit the encounter. Yeah, that's logical. Okay. Game is saved. Where was I? New map. Let's do it up. Once again, the moving badge. That's right. You managed to flee probably because they were too busy laughing at the piss run down your leg. Alright, that time I was successful. And let's refill water. Let's see. Radiation. Constant deadly threat. Visible as large green clouds. Right after is required to take damage from the radiation. Radiation suits. Special piece of equipment you can find. Water is a matter of life and death in the wasteland. Look for hidden wastes on the world map. Okay. Feeling nervous about this radiation. Let's get away from that, shall we? No, in fact, it looks like I got experience from running. I guess I don't get loot. But I got experience for running. Okay, let's do it.
Sir Arv and Randy ran away.
Citadel base, this is Echo 1.
Roger that, Echo 1.
Roger the target, over.
When you reach the area where Ace's body was found, give it a good going over. The folks that picked him up said it looked like he crawled there. Maybe you can find some tracks leading to where he was attacked. Copy?
Copy.
Spin 4, Echo 1, and check in immediately with any new info. Those repeater units are a top priority. Ranger Command out.
Okay. Let's see. So, let's save it. Now we're at the radio tower, which is as far as I ever got. On we go. Good night, Tyrone. Yeah, I agree, Miranda. Crusty red patches of blood. Okay. More blood.
I don't get shaken up easy. This place is sending shivers up my spine. God damn it, Ace. Why won't you let me come with you?
Oh, does it really? Oh, wow. Yeah, you're quite right. I think it would be helpful if I did that. Okay. Let's do some of that. So, let's see. Let's increase my leadership a little bit. Additional dialogue options. Bladed weapons, I think, is going to be next. Alright, so I'm going to save one skill point. Okay. Yeah. Oh, the skill points. Alright. Okay, so how do I stealth up on somebody? Book of Eli, Div. Book of Eli. How do I stealth up on somebody? If I even can. Can I do that? I mean, I see the crouching, but like... something better than a knife. Oh, there's no actual stealth mechanic? Okay. Well, you know what? I don't think I can see these guys, so we're gonna talk.
If you wanna play in our backyard, you gotta pay. 15 scrap, or we'll break your faces. And my dog will eat your corpses.
Let's see. Very intimidating. Let's see. But your backyard is in the ranger's front yard, so it cancels out, right?
Huh? Go ahead through while I try to figure that out.
Yeah!
Their front, our back.
Right. I'll be on my way.
Nothing, so we're even? Does that mean we're rangers too? I gotta go to my good think spot to figure this out.
Oh, yeah.
Guys, I'm heading west after my brain stops kicking my head.
You'll figure it out eventually.
He didn't die quiet, at least. He went down fighting. Damn it, Ace.
Guys, whenever you find yourself in a post-apocalyptic wasteland, keep in mind you're likely to be smarter than any person with a mohawk who is running around in a modified Chevy Impala. Okay, just keep that in mind. Thank you. A severed plastic leg lies on the ground, leaking an oily black liquid from torn hoses, tangled and caught on some rock half buried in the sand. The stuff is puddled, half congealed beneath the leg, and a metal bone visible through the hard plastic points towards more dark patches leading up a nearby incline. The leg is made of plastic and metal, scuffed and dented from hard use and badly mangled at the severed knee joint. Looks like it was removed from the rest of the body by a shotgun blast. Metal leg. Some kind of robot. Alright. Well, this is where he is, so this is where we keep going. Worn for the medical symbols, you look like the kind of cooler you take to the beach. Might have contained some healthful items. Who's my, next my trap specialist? Can't remember who my trap specialist is. Is it? Might be this one. Hey, what's up, Kilgore Trout? Good evening. Use perception to detect traps. Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna guess that means. Right. Pocket medic pack. Very nice. Ooh. Old Navy revolver and 38 ammo. Do I have anybody with regular guns? Just got an assault rifle. Old Navy revolver. You know what? He really needs something. He needs something, so I'm gonna give him. He's got a 10% chance of going rogue. That's interesting. I don't expect to be using this much, but just in case. Good to see you, Kilgore. Okay. Where's that blood leading? Leading that way. Into that cave!
Remember your failure at the cave.
I hope you guys are enjoying, by the way, what you're seeing and hearing. My name is Arvin Elleron. I play all sorts of games, but tend to focus on story and narrative-based games, and I do on this show, Pen and Pixels, which is currently episode number 19. Been streaming here now for almost 5 months, which is hard to believe. And if you like what you see and hear, please follow the channel. Consider following mine. I'm going to be playing here for another 50 minutes or so, and then when we get to 10 p.m. Eastern, I'll give way to Retrograde Tom, who's going to be playing some Legacy of Kain Soul Reaver for you, and I am going to be over at my channel about a half hour after that, playing some more of Demons of the Deep, which is a fighting fantasy game book where chat votes on the channel. Chat votes on the characters and on the decisions that are made. It's kind of like a cross between D&D and Choose Your Own Adventure. And I also have a couple of new emotes to show off on the channel as well. So head over there, / stay here for Retrograde Tom in about 50 minutes. Oh, and also, Kilgore, I have your epic poem done, sir. So I'll be reading your epic poem tonight. What could go wrong in this cave, right? Is that experience down below? Okay. Oh god. Well, crap. No! No! deadly toad! Don't attack me, toad! Toad, 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 toad. Gonna shoot you in the face, toad! Weapon jam? What the crap? That's fine, Kilgore, yeah. Facing a toad in the hole. Wow. Oh, I did. And it's Angela who missed, I can't imagine. Sawed off shotgun. This ought to be helpful. Blank. Let's spread out. All right. Wait a minute. There, look at this. This is all, okay, so this is all stuff that I'm gonna have to look at later on, because I found it while I was in the middle of the combat. Okay, I'm gonna have to go. I know, exactly. All right, let's see. Oh, Outstar. Ow! Nice. Oh, okay, that's good to know, Dizzy. That's good to know. Unjammed. Good. Let's have you crouch. And your turn. Oh, man. Let's see. Not enough AP. Right. Let's get over... Spread out over here, then. What? Did the toad just steal my freaking... What? Oh, goddammit. The toad just freaking stole my weapon. God damn it. That noise. I better be able to get this thing back. I better be able to get this weapon back. You will loot it off him? Okay. Toad eye. Members only jacket. All right. Okay. Alright, let's see. Now, what was this thing that I saw down here? At the end of the trail of black oil and gouged earth, you find a dead machine slumped against a metal chest. At least you think it's a machine. It's certainly mechanical, a 7-foot-tall man-shaped robot with metal and plastic legs, arms, torso, and head, all pockmarked with buckshot and covered in gashes that look like they were made by an axe. But there's something about the eyes of the thing that seem disturbingly human. Even dead and empty, they look like they may have once contained a soul. Near the mechanical man is a steel case and several items scattered across the ground. Amidst junked gears and spare parts, there's a hand-drawn map and a torn notebook page fluttering in the breeze. You recognize the page. It's from the regulation logbook that every ranger is issued when he signs up. Doc Brown, I think... Yeah. Nice. Well, you know, Miranda. The jacket was, too. Okay, so this is that mechanical man thing. All right, let's save it.
Damn. Look at that thing. Looks like Ace gave as good as he got. I guess that's some consolation. Where the fuck did it come from? Never seen a robot so advanced before. Not even Max was that tricked out.
Interesting. Desert Ranger Star has been crudely spray painted on the side of this steel case. Alright. Repeater unit.
That's Ace's gear, alright. What the hell was this metal asshole planning to do with it? We should poke around the cave. Make sure he didn't drop nothing else.
Okay, so this robot stole the repeater unit for some reason. Torn page from a ranger logbook. Okay, I'll do that. Thanks, Jin.
Looks like the robot only got one page of Ace's logbook. Don't say much. We should look around the area for more. Could be clues.
Yeah, how about you let me call the shots there, Angela? I never miss. Smeared with so much blood and oil that it was illegible. All right. So how do I... Okay, so reloading. How do I... Oh, that's out. Oh, that's out. Okay. The map is drawn on rough paper and spattered with oil, but the lines are so precise they look like they were done by a machine. The southern half of the state is soaked and torn, but the top is legible. In addition to Ranger Citadel, a location to the north, Rail Nomad Camp is circled.
This is what killed him. Goddamn piece of... I'm glad he's killed this fucking thing, but... I wish it was still alive so I could make it suffer.
Oh, okay, that's good to know. Computer science, Outstar, if you would. Aha, energy cell and a synth part. Critically succeeded. Look, okay, so you guys saw it. You guys saw it. Outstar Walker critically succeeded. So she's going to want to know that. So if you guys see her on tomorrow in chat or whatever, make sure you let her know that she critically succeeded. So far, my team is performing brilliantly with the overwhelming exception of Angela Death. Otherwise, my team has been off the hook. Alright, let me call.
Echo One, go ahead. Got an update for me?
Affirmative. Found the repeaters and the logbook. And a metal man.
What?
A dead robot. It looks like it killed Ace and stole the repeaters and logbook.
Well, I'll be goddamned. We haven't seen any synthetics around for almost 15 years. We better get a closer look at the tech. Mirror Captain might be able to tell us where it came from. See if you can grab a piece of it, and bring it back to Mirror Captain the next time you're at the Citadel.
It's fair enough, yeah. What is a synthetic?
That is Mercaptan's fancy word for smart robots. She calls them synthetic life forms, or synths. Basically, any robot that can think for itself falls into the synth category. Plain old robots are dangerous enough. Ones that think for themselves are a nightmare.
Roger. Received and understood, General.
Our priority is still those repeaters. Now that you have them, I'm sending you on to complete Ace's mission, which was to attach him to the most powerful towers in Arizona.
That toad is kind of freaking me out there.
Mystery signal. One tower is at High Pool, the other is at the Ag Center. Sending you the coordinates now.
The interesting thing, though, is about this rail nomads camp. Because I guess I should do the repeaters, but I do want to go to that rail nomad center, to find out more. You tell me about Ag Center?
Ag Center is due south of
Brenda?
Citadel and very important to what we're trying to achieve. The researchers there are developing hardier plants and animals that will thrive in the harsh conditions of the waste. If it all pays off, we may see the day when nobody in Arizona goes hungry. Talk to Matt Forrestal about hooking up to their radio dish. It used to be one of us. Now he runs things down there. Matt's good people.
Anything special about the dish?
Used to be part of an old satellite relay system, from what Woodson tells me.
Backup quarterback for the Vikings? Anything I should know about High Pool?
High Pool is at the most southern and eastern corner of our jurisdiction. They're a vital part of the stable society we've been trying to build here in Arizona. They provide clean water to us and many other communities and farms, maintain an emergency reservoir in case of drought. See Mayor Vikstrom there about using their tower. He knows you're coming.
You tell me about the tower?
They built their tower on top of an old crane. A bit unorthodox, but it gets great reception.
Copy, General. On our way.
Roger, Echo One. Ranger Command out.
You have gained enough experience in the field. Call General Vargas by using the radio in the upper right of the screen. All right.
Copy, Echo One. This is Ranger Command. Go ahead. Over.
Checking in to let you know we are making progress and still on the trail. Over.
Echo One, I'm happy to see several members of your team have earned field promotions. Congratulations, Echo One. You've done well.
Thank you, sir. Echo One out. That's a clever way to handle leveling. Okay. So good. All right. So now he's in a good position. So let's see. Unlock self-defense. Oh, that's yes. Yes, yes, yes. And let's see. Does it make more sense to push one particular, like, for example, I'd like to focus mostly on kiss-ass and smart-ass. Does it make more sense to kind of equally build up kiss-ass and smart-ass? Or does it make sense to kind of just, like max out a line? Yeah, I'm not going to go there right now. I'm going to do the mission first, Colton. Or Kotzen, rather. Kalte? Colton? So you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm trying to decide if it makes sense to just, like, focus my attention on, like, try to put more into kiss-ass first. Although smart-ass actually works several times, but I think kiss-ass is going to be more logical. It'll be case that only one speech skill will help you. Yeah, but I don't want to know about, like, from previous experience, this will be more useful than this. I'm just talking about in general terms, because this is my first playthrough. But just in general terms, does it make sense to kind of build over time, is my point. Right. I'm not gonna be spreading it out all over the place. That's what I'm thinking. What I'm thinking of is basically upping leadership, kiss ass, and smart ass. Emphasis on kiss ass, and then down to smart ass and leadership. So, alright, okay. Yes. Okay, now for you. I think you're okay in the field medic side. Long arm. What does long arm do? Increase more with shotguns. Junk diver. Is there a way I can know what that is? Junk diver? I'm looking at this toaster repair and I see that thing that says unlocks junk diver. Is there a way that I can know what that is or not? I'm not gonna keep putting only points in toast repair, but I'd like to do one of those there. Oh, my pleasure, DJ Tracy. Thanks for stopping by, man. Yeah. Under perks. That's not gonna let me look at it though. It's not gonna let me look at it. So what under this thing? Alright, well I'm gonna do it because I feel like that's what he would be. And we're gonna increase his shotgun. Oh, I can't increase his shotguns. I'm gonna do it. Okay. Let's find out, shall we? Upon finding a junk item, 50% chance of finding another junk item. Okay. Oh my gosh. That's funny. Does he have noble perks? No, he does not. Alright. What about you? You've got 5 skill points available, huh? Alright, well, let's put... No, it's literally the skill. It's like a wasteland thing. It's sort of... I think the computer skill was alright. And then I'm thinking about... So I want to up... I'm going to do these two. Hold on to 1 point. And Julia. Julia, my love. You have done very well for me so far. Oh, you have no skill points? Okay. Oh, you're almost leveled, but not quite. And whoa, check out Miss Level 7 over there. Could have fooled me, Angela Death. Good God, alright. That toad, though. Leveling up. I think I already did this. Upgrading characters. Thank you. I already did that. Alright, sounds good. Nightclub. Wonderful. Alright. So we did our job on that score. So when they level up, it seems like they get... So when they level up, they get healed. It sounds like they get healed when they level up, which is a nice little... That's a nice little feature. Something like that, Drake. Yeah, that's what I heard. Alright. So repeater time. Oops. Did I get out? Oh, nice. Okay, let's take a look at the map. Radio tower right there. There's another cave over there. I think Hypool makes sense to go next. So... Alright, see you, Dizzy. Fun indeed. What if these guys are still confused about what I was talking about? Cave entrance, raider camp. Thing can kill me. Alright. Splattered with blood, this console is connected to the radio tower's transmitter with a cobbled-together collection of wires. Attached to it is something that resembles one of the repeaters you salvaged. Ace must have just hooked this unit up when he was attacked. All right, cool. All right. No, I don't want to do that, Coates. And I want to get out and get to the next. I want to get out and get to the next step. I try to roleplay these a little bit, and although he is going to try to search things, I'm not going to be searching. We're going to be playing this game for long enough without him searching every single possible thing. So. The first shrine? What is a shrine? Alright, I'll go back in just because I want to see that, but what do you mean? So a shrine is free XP? Alright, I'm going to go do that just because I want to see what a shrine is, but then after that, I don't want to... I didn't fix the tower? What do you mean? I need to fix the tower? I thought the tower was already fixed. Why would I need to fix the tower?
Let me tell you Matthias' law, friends. Matthias' law is vengeance. And soon, Matthias' law will stretch all the way to Arizona.
Fair enough, Dragon.
Kill those so-called upholders of justice, the Desert Rangers.
Mechanical repair. Do it, Outstar. Okay, so now it's working? I guess. It looks like it's working. I feel like every post-apocalyptic thing has to have a guy named Matthias or Eli or something like that. I don't know whether they're going to be happy when I look at this box. I do not know. Ammunition property U.S. government. Bet you're not going to like it when I look at this. Oh. You don't actually care? Okay. Alright, let me check out the shrine then. Kinda wish it was like Baldur's Gate where you could on the world map select where you want to go. Alright, let's take a look at this other shrine, shall we? Oh, that I don't know. Toaster repair. Okay, guys, here we go. Let's see what happens. Toaster repair. We found some spray paint. Found some spray paint from some toaster repair. All right, what is this? Corpses of birds and mice in various stages of mutilation have been meticulously laid out. Limbs and half torsos placed with ritual precision in a complex pattern, encircling the statue of a cat. Admiring the statue fills your squad with a sense of purpose. It gives you a sense of determination. All right. Interesting. Toaster has spray paint. Apparently so. All right. He's got one skill point available. I thought he already had only one skill point available. He's got two. All right. So for him, let's throw one more point to shotgun. She's got two. Takes 4 points to up that, huh? All right, let's try to get them combat as combat worthy as I can earlier on. Exactly, Sharian. Yeah, but again, I have to be careful about that because I don't want to just be, you know, searching everywhere for everything. Oh, she's got a skill point. It's available. For, you know, because basically, oh, she's got an outdoorsman. All right, that's kind of cool. Because basically, I want to make sure that I'm RPing it at least a little bit. Okay, she can hold on to that for now. What happens if I call this guy? I'm going to save it first. I know, right, Jedi Knight?
Copy, Echo One. This is Ranger Command. Go ahead. Over. Copy, Echo One. Appreciate the update.
Okay. Okay. I need a lesser dog to pet. It's so true. Okay. Now let's get the hell out of Dodge, and let's see. I probably will have a chance just to get to the next area before we're gonna want to run the raffle, and... and get ready to give way to Tom. Boop da boop doop doop boop. Bomp da bomp bang a bang booga da 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 da. Yeah, that's fair enough. No, because I want to save this one last time at the radio tower. Oh, wow. Hold on a second. It doesn't just overwrite the quick save? Oh. It's kind of obnoxious. Alright. Let's do it. R feels the boogie. Alright. So now I have to decide if I want to go to... High Pool or the Ag Center. I think I'm going to go to High Pool first. And then we're going to hit the Ag Center. And then I'd like to hit the Rail Nomads Camp, but I might go back to the Citadel first. But let's go to the High Pool first. Moving badge, moving badge, moving, moving, moving badge. Da, 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 I'm driving.
SOS! SOS! Is anybody out there? This is High Pool. We are under attack. I repeat, we are under attack. Raiders with mortars and explosives are blasting our walls.
Radiation.
If anybody can hear this, come at once. Don't know how long we can hold them.
Ranger Citadel, this is Ag Center. Come in. We're under attack. The plants, they're mutating out of control. They're tearing my people apart.
Oh, great. Really?
Ag Center, this is Citadel Base. Can you repeat? Did you say the plants were attacking?
Yes, goddammit, the plants! Something's gone wrong with the... Look! The door! They're breaking down the door! Fall back! Fall back!
Ranger Team Echo, this is Ranger Command. Come in. Did you copy those distress calls from High Pool and Ag Center? Over.
Affirmative. Message received.
Roger that. Listen, Echo One, I have no one else in the area and no further intel at this time. I'm afraid it's going to have to be your decision which call to respond.
Of course
first.
It is.
Whichever one you choose, get there ASAP.
Where's Rachel?
Both situations are emergencies and both sounded like they were deteriorating rapidly. Copy?
Both places you sent us to were suddenly having emergencies?
Uh-huh. Suspicious, isn't it, Echo One? Like someone's monitoring our transmissions... trying to stop our little radio experiment before it starts. Keep an eye out for suspect characters. Copy?
Hey, what's up, George? What's up, George Ledoux? I should say, if you guys don't know, George Ledoux in chat is a member of the Our Vocalists vocal team that does voiceovers for me once a month on my channel, and they have done a tremendous job so far. They voiced the first day of Undertale in one of the most hilarious game sessions I've ever had, and they're going to be doing next week, February 11th, well, I guess 9 days from now, February 11th, they're going to be doing the conclusion of Undertale. So if you haven't already, George is a pro. He's been doing this for 20 years plus and is a very good guy. And George, your name came up because as people were listening to one of the guys here, they immediately were saying you were the person they thought of to do this voice. So he's the person. So yeah, George is awesome. I'm very, very fortunate to have him on the team. Okay, yes, I copy.
10-4 Echo 1, Godspeed.
Godspeed. Let's run. What? Come on, man. 75% chance. All right. Well, this combat's going to be the last that I'm going to be able to do. You want the knife? Get the knife. Wow. Ow. Well, crap. This is a wonderful position. What a lovely, lovely position I find myself in. Tremendous. No, how about if I get... Okay. Oh, Julia. Julia, my love. Did I while I was playing in the radiation? I was so busy trying to get out of it that I wasn't even paying attention. Okay. Let's see. Angela. Angela, Angela, Angela. Can you actually hit someone for once? Would that be possible? Because it would be really awesome if you could do that. Nice! Well done, Angela. You're back on the team. Good job, Angela. Ah. It's alright, though. I'll take it. Doc, if you would. I don't think that's going to hit Julia. And it didn't. That's my team, people. Ladies and gentlemen, my team. All right, let's get here. I was thinking the same thing, George. Oh, God, don't hit her. Don't hit her. Don't hit her. You son of a... Listen, you don't hit Julia. You don't hit Julia. God damn it, he's out of range. You don't hit Julia on my watch. To swap weapons. No, I'm gonna pull up close to him, but I'm not gonna swap weapons. I'm gonna ambush just in case he comes close to me. Right, Angela. Please do not miss. Good girl. All right. Nice. I will take it. I will take it. Good thing I showed up. Angela finally did something. No, I mean, it worked out. It worked out. It worked out. All right, I got to heal them, too. We got a pocket medic pack. That's good, because I'm about to use it. Oh, wait, 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 wait. What was that? What was that? Oh, a necklace. It's junk. All right. Let's, okay. Doc. If you would, please, let's heal yourself first. And let's also heal. Let's heal Julia. Lovely. Okay, I think you're okay for now. All right, let's get out of here. Which one leveled up so they'll heal? Oh, she leveled up? Oh, goddammit.
Copy, Echo 1. This is Ranger Command. Echo 1, your recent progress
merits
a field promotion for one of your... Congratulations, Echo 1.
My bad. I didn't look. My bad. Oh, well. Now I know. I will learn to be more careful. All right. 4 skill points. She's doing awesome so far, but I feel like... Is there any benefit to increasing perception with her? Is there any benefit to doing that? Do you guys know or not? Because if not, I'm going to give her Watchmen because I think, you know what, I'm going to give her Watchmen. But then I'm going to want to know about perception down the line. What is Watchmen? You're able to take snapshots at enemies with ease. Other rangers in your squad can feel safe knowing you're watching out for them. Oh, I actually have to, I have to get enough perk points to use this. No chance to hit penalty when using a ambush. That's pretty sweet. Yes equals greater range. Okay, all right. You recognize the voice of that radio guy? Yeah, I was wondering. I mean, you would know more about than I would, George. But I was wondering because I definitely, the name seems distinctive to me somehow, but I don't know why. Yes. Okay. All right. Cool. I will keep that in mind. I'll probably give her perception the next. All right. I just want to get here. Want to get here. Oh yeah, there's that cache you were talking about. I will look at that when I leave Highpool, which will not be now. So far, I'm pretty happy with the combat prowess on this team. Citadel Base, this is Echo 1. We've arrived
Roger,
at Highpool. Over.
Now listen, I want you to deal with the emergency situation first, before proceeding to the antenna. Repeat, help Mayor Vikstrom with his emergency, then hook up the repeater to the antenna on their crane. Protecting civilians is always a Ranger's number one priority. Do you copy? Roger, Echo 1.
Copy.
Advise when complete. Ranger Command out.
All right, attach the repeater units. Oh, you know, I never got the rest of Ace's logbook, did I? I bet I needed to search more. Shoot. I needed to search more. Well, crap. All right, I'm going to have to go back and search more. That's a shame. But I'll have to do that at a later time. So I'm going to deal with Highpool, and then we'll deal with the Ag Center. And then I'll have to, after that, go back and try to deal with getting the rest of his logbook. I didn't realize. All right, so this game just makes you search everything all the time. All right, that's fine. I was trying to kind of balance it off against wanting to do things in a relatively expeditious manner, but perhaps that was not the way to go. All right. Oh, wow, nice. Nice, nice, nice. Cool. Very, very cool. All right, guys. Well, that was fun. So far, so good. I'm enjoying it. So far, this is kind of neat. I'm enjoying it partly because I'm enjoying the fact that my team is not getting obliterated in combat. So I guess you guys did a good job with your suggestions. So that's awesome. I'm glad to see that we're making some advancements. So far, kind of an interesting story. I like that robot. Little twist. I like that. We'll see what else we can come up with out of that. All right. With that said, let's get something done down here. We're gonna close this. And we're going to reset it. And there we go. All right. So now, guys, you can type in. That's kind of what I thought, too, Jim. All right, guys, you can now type in the raffle. You can type in your raffle. And you're going to get a game code. I'm going to give you, I believe, a $9.99 game code. This particular version that I'm playing is more expensive. This particular one that I'm playing, this director's edition with all director's cut with all the other stuff, is $39.99. So this is more expensive, but I'm still... So I'm going to do the best I can, which is this $9.99 code. But I think... there are a lot of good games. I know there are a lot of good games on here anyway. So, yes. Okay. And then as soon as the raffle is done, I will, as soon as the raffle is done, I will give way to Retrograde Tom, who's going to be playing some Legacy of Kain Soul Reaver. And then again, just as a reminder, in about a half hour over on my channel at 10:30 Eastern, I'll be back live streaming. I'm going to be showing you guys a couple of new emotes that the channel has on Better TTV. And we're going to be continuing with this, which is Demons of the Deep. We're going to be continuing with Demons of the Deep, which is a fighting fantasy game book where you are chat votes on the actions of the character. So far, the character is underwater and has a water-breathing spell and is trying to find his way back. His name is, I believe, Gurgle Drowningberg. Don't blame me. I believe it is Spurious for these terrible names. But no, just kidding. But in any case, so feel free to join up with that. Check out the emoticons. And I've also got my two epic poems written that I'm going to be reading out for last month, reading out to Trendane and to Kilgore Trout when they get into chat. So all that stuff is there. Please make sure. Yes, the new emotes are live, Thorg, and you know something about them. And we'll talk more about that. So Gurgle Drowningberg. Oh, thank you, Kilgore. And Kilgore is going to be getting his epic poem benefit as well. Yes. So all that stuff, Patreon and that stuff can happen as well. I know, right, George? This is what happens when I let people... This, I'm telling you, man. This is what happens when I let people make their own decisions. But anyway, so that'll be over at my channel. As for me, I will be back here 1 week from today, Tuesday at 7 p.m. Eastern. We will continue with Wasteland 2. I do want to remind everyone, just as a heads up, though, that I am going to be doing a series of the Agatha Christie games at some point. Probably not next week, but some point within the next month. I expect to do a series that I'm going to start of the Agatha Christie game, the ABC Murders. I'm going to play that for a few sessions. When that's done, I'll go back to Wasteland 2, and I'll stick with Wasteland 2 from that point forward. But I'm kind of anxious to avoid being the guy who plays one game for 7 consecutive months and then goes on to something else. So I'm going to have something in the middle to break it up a little bit. But the two games are going to be the Agatha Christie ABC Murders thing, and then Wasteland 2 is what I'm going to be doing on this channel. And as far as my own channel, you can go over there and check out that as well. Oh, is you Jedi? Okay, I couldn't remember. Yeah, Gurgle Drowningberg. God help it. You get you don't get new emotes, but you'll get some other things. You don't get emotes, but you will see. But we'll talk more about that over on my channel. So a reasonable name. Yes, it has been so far. All right. Last call on the raffle, guys. Last call on the raffle. I'm going to close this down. Last call on the raffle, please. Okay, and here we go. The winner is Uncle Elias. I wouldn't surprise me, Ekeg, because I'm going to, I mean, think about it. If I'm playing, congratulations, Uncle Elias. Let me know if you're in. Yeah, right, Strike. What's up, dude? Ekeg, I mean, if I'm playing 3 hours a week on this channel, that means I'm playing an average of about 20 to 23 hours a month, right? This game, as far as I know, well, okay, maybe that's a little bit extreme. Maybe I'm going to be playing it for like 3 months, but the game's got to be at least like 60 hours, I'm guessing. So it's gonna be a while, I would guess. Okay, let's see. Uncle Elias, did I see you, Uncle Elias? Where are you? There you are. You won this time, Uncle Elias. You won this time. I'm going to send you a code. Hold on 1 second. I'm going to do it right this moment. Hold on 1 second. Always good to see an Arvanaut, a person who's an Arvanaut also becoming part of the experience of GOG. Congratulations. There you go. I have sent it off to you. It is on its way. And yes, you are in good shape, Uncle Elias. So congratulations on that raffle. And close. And reset and all good to go. Lovely. All right, guys, that's going to do it for me. Up next again is Retrograde Tom at the top of the hour at 10 p.m. Eastern. And as I say, I'll be back on my channel at about 10:30 p.m. Eastern to follow up with some more of the Fighting Fantasy Gamebook. After that, we're going to be continuing with Undertale later on this week. With the R Vocalist next week with that. Also, we're going to be continuing with the Infinity and Beyond crew and D&D this weekend also. So lots of good things happening. If you like what you saw and heard, please follow me over at my channel, and especially please follow all the wonderful people here at GOG. And definitely be around, because there's some cool stuff happening, guys. Some very, very exciting stuff that's happening over the next few days. So make sure you stay tuned into GOG for all of the juicy details. That's it for me. Thanks all so much. It was a great time. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I will catch all of you folks next week for episode 20 of Pen and Pixels, and on my channel throughout the week after that. That's it. Have a wonderful night. I'll talk to you all soon. Be good to each other. Have a good day.
Sun is hidden far from me.